familiar story of the angel Gabriel appearing to Mary to share with her the prayers that she had found favor with God and was now being called to bear the Christ child. This passage, which we actually hear many times during the liturgical year, is beautiful and poetic, and it really has inspired lots of artists and poets and even musicians for centuries. Sometimes I wonder about the details that we don't necessarily hear about. For instance, what was the young Mary doing when the angel arrived? Was she preparing dinner? Was she cleaning the house? Praying? Or something else? Did the angel knock on the door to make his presence known, even though there's no reference to that? One artist portrays a beam of light coming through the window, shining upon Mary as she sits there, almost like in a trance, listening to the words of God. We just don't know. And then, what did Mary do after the angel departed? Did she excitedly tell her parents what had happened? Were they around? How did she react? Did she immediately start packing some clothing and head off to the hill country to visit Elizabeth, who she learned was also the child? We don't really know. We might also wonder how Mary approached Joseph to tell him what happened. We know that Joseph was disturbed by the news and was going to separate from Mary. Yet an angel also appeared to him to assure him that the child that was conceived was the Son of God, and that he should accept Mary as his wife. So there's so many details that we don't know about the particular story, the human side of it. What did people experience? What was it like? How did they respond? But the one thing that is important that we know of for sure, that Mary's yes forever changed human history and human life. Mary's yes actually moves us closer to Christmas, which is why we observe this feast day exactly 9 months from Christmas. This day is appropriately called the Annunciation because it involves an announcement by God. And if we read through the scriptures, we see that God makes a series of announcements from the time of creation through the coming of Christ. God was always announcing his plan of salvation through the patriarchs, through the prophets, through all the people who preceded Jesus. And now God announces his plan in full to the Virgin Mary. He shares with her how he is going to save the world from sin. The fact is, God is continually announcing things to us each day. When the sun rises, God is announcing that we have arrived to a new day. When the sun sets, God announces that the day for us is done. Throughout life, God announces to us that we are his children by baptism. He announces to us that we are forgiven when we repent of our sins. He announces that the kingdom is ready and that we can inherit it if we choose. God also announces the presence of his own Son to us each time we gather here to receive the Eucharist. So, how do we respond to all of these revelations, to all of these things that God is announcing to us each day? We respond with a deep sense of gratitude. God has announced to us his plan of salvation. May we respond with a faithful yes, as did Mary.